This has got to be like top five on the list of frustrating reasons students miss exam questions. But not you. You're going to nail it. Hi, biology people. It's Sarah, and I'm your other biology professor. And today we're going to clear up what's happening with five prime and three prime ends on DNA and RNA. So, DNA and RNA, their sequences are just a bunch of letters stuck together, right? Like for DNA, it's A and C and G and T. And for RNA, it's A and C and G and U. And while that doesn't mean a lot to us, those sequences mean a lot to the cell. Five prime and three prime give a sense of directionality. So here's a bunch of letters, and when we read them from left to right, it's awesome, right? But from right to left, not so great. So, without any context on which direction to read this sequence, how would you know? The building blocks of DNA and RNA are called nucleotides. And there are some important differences between DNA and RNA nucleotides, but they're not important for this conversation, so we're going to ignore them for right now. We can combine these little guys to make our big, important molecules. But which direction does it go? Should we be reading this green, red, blue, yellow, or the opposite? Of course, a nucleotide is a bit more complicated, right? We've got our nitrogenous base, we've got our phosphate, and we've got our sugar. And it's the sugar that's really important for this three prime and five prime conversation. The sugars in our nucleotides have five carbons. And we can keep track of the carbons by numbering them. And we do this 1 prime, 2 prime, 3 prime, 4 prime, 5 prime. Why the prime? Well, that's because we also number the carbons in the nitrogenous base, and by chucking a prime on there, it helps keep things separate. So the side of the nucleotide closest to the 5 prime carbon, up by the phosphate end, is the 5 prime end. And the 3 prime end is the side down by the 3 prime carbon, where the flat part of the sugar is, the sort of sugar butt part. So now the cell knows how to read our sequence. We have a sense of directionality. And as you know, directionality is super important in molecular processes like DNA replication, transcription, and translation. We need to know which way to read our sequence. I want to wrap up by pointing out three places that tend to trip students up a bit. The first, keep in mind that when we bring together complementary sequences of nucleic acids, so this could be DNA, DNA in a double helix, or this could be DNA pairing with RNA in a process like transcription, the nucleic acid strands are going to come together in a way that is anti-parallel, running 5 prime to 3 prime in opposite directions. The second is to beware of sort of backward sequences. So we typically write codons 5 prime to 3 prime. That's how you'll see them in the codon table. But sequences can be written in a reverse direction. So keep in mind that a sequence like 5 prime AGU 3 prime is the same sequence as 3 prime UGA 5 prime. So, depending on how generous your professor is being with the sequences you get on an exam, you may have to flip some things around. The third piece is simply just recalling the directionality of our important molecular processes. Keep in mind that whenever you're synthesizing nucleic acids, when you're building them, you're always going to add on to the 3' end of the growing molecule. And that's true of both DNA and RNA. I hope this helped to clear up some of the drama around 5' and 3' ends. And if it did, please give me a like to help other students see this as well. Subscribe so you can get even more biology content from me, and I will see you next time.